Aquarius, welcome back to Angels Light Tarot. Thank you for stopping by for your weekly general message for March the 2nd through March the 8th. Now, you guys know I typically do not do romantic weekly love messages, but I am going to do a bonus one card message for the lovebirds, and here it is. Okay, the silver waterfall. So, in your romantic sector, the question is, do you see love the way it truly is? Or do you see your love as you wish them to be, right? I feel like a lot of people may be looking at your love partner like, what do you see in that person? But you know what? You're seeing your person like, oh my God, they're so handsome, or they're so beautiful, or they're so smart. And other people are saying, what are they looking at? Right? So you keep doing you. You keep loving who you see in front of you, okay? But just be aware, other people may be giving you that side eye like, what do you see in that person? Okay, so moving on for the general message. Okay, angels and guides, we are looking for Aquarius. What is going on for Aquarius? Positive energy, please. Positive energy for Aquarius for 7 little days. General message for Aquarius. What is going on, angels? What's the positive energy around Aquarius? Positive energy for Aquarius. 7 little days, angels. Just 7 little days. Just 7. We're looking for a bonus here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And yes, yes, yes. My mama's deck, Aquarius. Positive energy, please. Positive energy for Aquarius. What is going on for Aquarius? 7 little days, angels. Just 7 little days. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And yes, the next deck. Positive energy, please. For Aquarius, 7 little days. 7 little days, Aquarius. What is going on? 7 little days, Aquarius. Positive energy, please. Positive energy for Aquarius. I feel like, whoa, you know what? I'm just going to leave that there. This is going to be a lengthy read. So please, 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 please get your tea, get your coffee, or get whatever it is that you drink. What do you drink? Put it down below. Angels and guides, positive energy for Aquarius for 7 little days. That is it. Just 7 little days. Bum, bum, bum. Angels, what is going on for 7 little? I feel like that goes there. I feel like that goes there. Yes, it does. And may we have one more, angels. And there it is. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Whew. Are we ready? Let's get right into this, Aquarius. Major theme for the week is the Ace of Cups reversed with the 4 of Diamonds and the 7 of Clubs, the new beginning, and the Angel of Diversity. So for the, I feel like this week there's a bit of you're wanting something to get off the ground. You're definitely emotionally wanting something to move forward. And it's like you're pushing and the universe is pushing back. You're pushing and the universe is pushing back. And I feel like you're doing this because you need this security. You definitely need security in whatever this is you're wanting to start, right? But, and I feel like there is an element of, there might be some energies around it that are maybe not so positive while you're pushing. I feel like it's an agenda. You're pushing an agenda. It might be you, or it might be a cross watcher. If whatever this agenda is, it has something to do with a brand new beginning. And the Angel of Diversity, I see someone trying on different hats, different ways to approach the situation that is not getting off the ground. Try it this way. Yes, because you're looking for this new beginning and you're trying. I feel like you just, can I do it this way? Can I do it that way? Can I do it this way? And the universe is like, okay, we're trying to meet you, right? And I feel like the more you release that negative energy, the more you let the negative energy go, then you have the potential to seeing a different creative way to handle this situation, okay? Now, When we look in the recent past, Aquarius, we have the King of Pentacles reversed with the Three of Clubs and the Six of Clubs with the third eye chakra with the Angel of Choice. So in the recent past, there was definitely, I feel like you didn't feel in control. No, you did not. And you know what? You didn't like it because I feel like you're used to being in control. You did not like this at all. It worried you. It definitely worried you. It may have even caused some arguments or someone getting the silent treatment. Now, however, if there was no type of communication or the communication was small, I feel like the third eye chakra, I feel like you still communicated psychically, right? And that was your choice, the Angel of Choice. Even though you felt your power was being taken away, that was your choice to remain in that energy, if that makes sense. Now, when we look in the middle of the week, Aquarius, we have the Five of Cups with the Jack of Spades and the King of Clubs with the Victory and Success and the Angel of Fidelity. So what I'm feeling in the middle of the week is an element of feeling a bit uncertain emotionally, like something is uncertain and you're not very happy about it, right? And I feel like you're feeling there's some shenanigans going on with this Jack of Spades, but I definitely feel with this King of Clubs, it's saying take the high road, okay? Definitely take the high road, and there lies your success. And, you know, be committed to the Angel of Fidelity, be committed to taking the high road, okay? Now, Even if there's things you're feeling like, well, this doesn't make sense and that doesn't make sense, and I think there's not a truth here, or blah, 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 take the high road and commit yourself to that, okay? Now, when we look to the end of the week, we have the Ten of Cups reversed with the Seven of Spades and the Nine of Spades with movement and choices and decisions with the Angel of Security. So by the end of the week, you're feeling like love is there. It is definitely there. But you're not feeling like, you know, you have a direct line to it. You know it's there. You know it's capable of being there. And this could be with family, friends, tons of family. But you're not feeling the love from them, right? And I feel like this is making you feel a bit, you know, uncertain. You're not happy with the fact that they're not giving you the love that you deserve. You're ready with the Nine of Spades. You're ready to let all of this go. You have to make a choice. You definitely have to make a choice and a decision for your own security. So there lies, yes, it's almost like someone is not agreeing with you, okay, in your family or your circle of friends. Now, and I feel like once you make this decision, yes or no, it's always a yes or a no, I feel like then you will get your security and you will feel very powerful. Now, when we look at your bonus, you have the five of swords reversed with the Knight of Pentacles reversed with the Six of Cups reversed and the Jack of Hearts, the Queen of Diamonds. Accelerated motion, wisdom, a lot, fertility, and the waiting game with the Angel of Guidance. So what I'm feeling here is I feel like there has been a separation, and or you've been thinking about it. And if there isn't a separation, you've been thinking about it. But I feel like this week you're going to change and maybe not so much. Maybe I don't need this separation. I don't feel like it's an act of separating. I feel like it's an act of thinking about separating, right? And I feel like this week your mind will definitely change in that regard. With the Knight of Pentacles reverse, I see you staying where you are because you find some value in that. With the Six of Cups, I feel like there is an element of emotional, it's more of the value is, it's the emo, it's like there's something that is not emotionally clicking, but there's still value there, right? With the Queen of Diamonds, I feel like this may have something to do with resources, if you will. Maybe spending too much, maybe spending too little, but either way, it's agitating you a bit, right? You're ready. I feel like you're ready to move forward. You're ready to move forward with wisdom, with fertility. You're ready for this to grow, but the waiting game. You're feeling the waiting game. And I feel like the angel, seek guidance, the angel of guidance, because I feel like there is a sacrifice that needs to be made or will be made. So this bonus is basically telling us that the value, I feel like there's something emotionally that you're detached from, and it's more of the value of something versus the heart, the emotions. It's almost like you're cutting off your emotions, or someone else is cutting off their emotions, and it's more geared towards what is the value in this. And sometimes we see the value more in, it's like, you know, let's say you're hypothetically speaking, you're a mom and you have 5 kids, 6 kids, and you're married, and you're thinking, you know, I'm not really happy here, but I got 5 kids to feed. I have 5 kids to take care of, and I don't want to see them struggle. So it's almost like, yeah, I'm not happy here, but I see the value in staying. Okay, so I send you joy, namaste, and much, much love sent your way.